So in this video, we will discuss one of the important problems which can be developed, solution can be developed using dynamic programming, that is finding the transitive closure of the graph. So this is developed using Warshall's algorithm. Transitive closure of a graph, so basically we know that for a connected graph, the adjacency matrix of that graph A is given by every elements from I to J of this adjacency matrix will be equal to 1 if there is a edge from I to J. Otherwise it will be 0. Sometimes we may be interested in finding whether there exists a path from I to J, any two arbitrary vertices we take, if there is a path from I to J, if we want to find it, then we have to define the transitive closure of the graph. Transitive closure of a graph is a n by n matrix. If there are n number of vertices for a connected graph, then the every element of that matrix Cij will be equal to 1, if there is a path, a non-trivial path with any number of intermediate vertices from I to J. Otherwise it will be equal to 0. Say for example, we will not understand the definition only once. Consider a problem, a graph, connected graph. This. See, if the graph is like this, then the cost adjacency matrix A will be like this. Is there any edge from A to A? No edge. A to B, there is a edge. A to C, there is no edge. A to D, there is no edge. B to A, there is no edge. B to B, no edge. B to C, no edge. B to D, there is an edge. C to A, there is no edge. C to B, no edge. C to D, C to C, no edge. C to D, no edge. From D, D to A, there is an edge. D to B, no edge. D to C, there is the edge. D to D, there is no edge. So this is the adjacency matrix of this graph. So if we want to find the transitive closure of this graph, if there is a path from one vertex to other vertex, then with any number of intermediate vertex, then that will be 1. Say for example, is there any path from A to A? Yes, it is. There is a path from A to A, that is A to B, B to D, B to A. So it is 1. A to B, already there is a path. A to C, there is a path. A to B, B to D, B, D to C, there is a path. And A to D, there is a path. As we are human beings, we can see and we can enter. If the graph is too hard, too complex, or too big, then we need to develop a procedure to find this kind of transitive closure of a graph. So that can be developed with this Warshall's algorithm. Okay, we will see how this method works. So what it does is, it goes on developing intermediary matrices. Where the first matrix will be same as that of the adjacency matrix, and these intermediary matrices will be calculated based on the previous one. Say for example, RK matrix will be found from the RK minus 1. Say how it is, if you consider this row and this column, in this situation, say this is kth row and kth column. An entry of ith row and jth column, ith row and jth column will be 1 if RK, in the RK entry, it will be 1 if RK minus 1 of that is already 1. Otherwise, it will be 1 only if R I K entry is 1 and R K J entry will be 1. That is R I J of K will be equal to R I J of K minus 1. If already it is 1, fine. Otherwise, or R I J of K minus 1, that is K is the number of intermediate vertices, and R I K J of K minus 1. So it means that there is a path from 1 to 2 already exists. This is one path. If there is no path from 1 to 2 directly, there may be path from 1 to 4, 4 to 5, 5 to 2. If with 2 intermediate vertex means K is equal to 2. If there is only 1 intermediate vertex means K will be equal to 1. So it is going to find Rij of K by the previous entry of Rij of K minus 1 or Rik Rkj. So Rik Rkj, like this. So we will solve the same problem what we have considered here for this graph. What we have drawn, that is A to B, D, this is what we had taken. So R naught will be the given adjacency matrix. R naught will be given adjacency matrix, that is 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, the same matrix I am writing again, 0, 0, 0, 0, this is 1, 0, 1, 0. So to find R1, you can write here like this. We need to consider this row and this column. So those rows and columns will not be changed here because they are not affected by the algorithm. So they will remain as it is. See that this is 0. This is 0. So even there is one, this row will not be changed because either this should be 1 or this and this should be 1. So in that, this is already 0. That is Rik of K minus 1. This is K minus 1. This is K we are calculating. So this is already 0. So this will not be affected. So it is 0, 0, 1, This is 0, so this remains as it is. Now this is 1. So there are chances of change in this rule. So this is 1 and this is also 1. So this one will constitute this one. This is R I K of my K minus 1 and this is R K J of K minus 1. So this 0 is changed to 1. So it means that there is a path from D to B, that is D to B, there is a path D to A to B with one intermediate vertex. So R D A R A B, there are one. So then, so this one needs to consider, already one is there, so it will not change. And this is 0, this is 1 and this is 0, so it is 0. Now we need to go for this row and this column, second row and second column, meaning that with two intermediate vertices, is there any path between two arbitrary vertices? So now R2 can be calculated like this: A, B, C, D, A, B, C, D. See that we need to write this row and this column as it is. They will not be affected because they are the things we have considered. And this is 0. So if it is 0, this column will not be affected. So we will keep it as it is. Now this is also 0, so we will not change it as it is. Keep it as it is. Now this is 1 and this is 1. So only thing that is going to change is this entry. So that will become 1, and as this is 0, the remaining will be as it is. And this is 1, so this entry will be changed. I hope you are getting. This is 1 and this is 1. So both of these 1 will constitute or will change this 0 to 1. It means that there is a path from A to B with two intermediate vertices. There is a path from D to B with two intermediate vertices. So there is a path from D to B with two intermediate vertices. Then we need to calculate R3. Now we need to consider third row and third column. See that third row entry is 0, so nothing is going to change in from R2 to R3. We will write it as it is. Now to find R4, which is the last one, because there are four vertices, so we need to find at max Rn. That will give us the transitive closure of the graph. So we need to consider the last row and last column. That they are not going to change. We will write them directly. Now, as these all are 1, we need to check whether these are 1. This is 1, this is also 1, so whole thing will become 1. And this is 1, this is 1, so this will also become 1. This is 1, this is 1, so it will also become 1. This is 1 and this one is 1, so it will also become 1. This is 0, but so it will not be affected. So it means that by seeing this, matrix, we can call this as transitive closure of the graph. See that there is no path from C to any other vertices, but there are paths from all the other vertices to all other vertices. There may not be single edge path, but there may be arbitrary path with any number of vertices in between. So how we can develop this algorithm? There is a small pseudocode we can think of. See, to traverse the matrix, we need two for loops. So for I is equal to 1 to n, and for j is equal to 1 to n. Now we have taken intermediate number, that is the number of vertices. For that, we will consider for k is equal to 1 to n. We have calculated Rij of k will be equal to Rij of k minus 1. If it is 1, fine. Or Rik of k minus 1 and Rkj, I to k, k to j. If both of these are 1, then this will be 1, or if this is already 1, there will not be any change in this. This is what the simple pseudo code we can think of. This is the Warshall's algorithm. See that we can also do this with DFS traversal or DFS traversal. If we consider this vertex, from this, is there any path to all the other vertices? Using DFS and DFS, we can do that. But we need to go in an exhaustive search way. That is, we need to traverse this matrix many times. We need to traverse this graph many times, either with the DFS or DFS. But in this case, in this tabular method of dynamic programming, we have calculated the overlapping subproblem solutions intermediately, that is sequence of decisions we have taken, and using this step, the memorization technique, that is tabulation technique, then we have arrived at the solution. So this algorithm, there are three for loops, so by default it will take theta of n cube, which we may find that it is costly, the time complexity is more. For the sparse matrix, these will give the better result, but space consumption is less because only once we are recording the intermediate results. Okay, and also we can improve this algorithm, improve this by using a bitwise OR operator on most of the sophisticated programming languages, so we can get the results very quickly. So this is one of the very important implementation of dynamic programming. Just we are going to find the intermediate matrix by considering the previous matrix, rows and columns.